So first, please check out step 02. If you open the easy site, you will need to see everything that you have completed. So the menu with the cart, with the login and register, and regular easy site. Okay, our first task is here. So the first task we need to implement adding product to the cart with Ajax. So what we need to do is first to override two bundles from the Sylius. So Sylius Web Bundle and Sylius Core Bundle. Sylius Web Bundle is for templating. So we will keep that as our, let's call it front-end bundle. And Sylius Core Bundle is our actually application bundle. So all custom logic that we will do through the tasks today, we will handle there. And all templating things that we will need to add, we will keep them in a web bundle. I use the namespace Easy Sylius, so you can use it also, or you can use any of your namespace. The only important thing is that your parent of your bundles are Sylius Core and Sylius Web Bundle. We will seal that. After we extend these two controllers, of course, we need to attach them in a kernel, and then we need to create custom Sylius cart item controller and override our action to return the JSON array with count items and cart total. Also, we need to extend page head script and add Sylius JavaScript frontend files, add some custom JavaScript for handling our Ajax call, and that's basically it. How to override Sylius cart item controller is just a matter of configuration. So as I say before, everything is a service in Sylius, so the controllers are also the services. And we can override them simply just changing the configuration file. So I can start doing this, and then maybe you can try it, little things to do by yourself. And then I will show you the full example of the code. So at the moment, I'll try to full screen this view presentation mode. Okay. Okay, so at the moment in our source code, we have only Netgen namespace inside source folder. We will need to add our new bundles here. So let's start with that. Can you all see what I'm doing here? You can read the font. It's okay. Okay, this is something to start with. So for extending these two Sylius bundles, we just need to enter parents here. So for core bundle, it's simple. It's Sylius core bundle. For web bundle, it's same thing. It's just Sylius web bundle. Okay. The only thing that we need to do is add them to kernel. Okay, are you familiar with this type of overriding, the bundles? Is there anyone who didn't do this before? Okay. So basically, that's the first part of our tasks. Now let's jump a little bit to the Sylius and see how things are configured inside the Sylius application. If you open the vendor folder, you will see entire Sylius application here. So there is also app, Sirs, Travis, Vagrant, web, entire Symfony application is in our inside our vendor folder, inside Sylius folder. If you open the bundle folder, you will get the old bundles from Sylius. The same thing is from components. Okay. We talk about that at the first part of my presentation. And the most interesting thing at the moment is this core bundle for us. Okay. If we go to resource config app, we will get the Sylius configuration file. It's just a regular YAML file with all configuration things that we need to for all bundles to work together in a core in our application, actually. So in this task, we need to work with the Sylius controller cart item, so we can search for that and see how it is configured. So it's a part of the Sylius cart bundle. You can read that from the from this line. We have some resolver for that, and then we have some classes. For crude operation inside the Sylius application, there is a resource bundle. You can use even that resource bundle without Sylius application for any of your application. It resolves the create, read, update, delete things, and it's quite easy to configure. So here is the part of configuration for that resource bundle. We have some item, or for example, the taxonomy, taxon anything. That's the name of our entity, of our model. And then we, for that class, for that model, we can define model, form, controller, validation groups, and everything that we need. So basically, in a Sylius cart, we are using custom model from our core bundle, and we are using controller from the cart bundle as a default. As I said, there is no documentation, but if we open the cart bundle, we can read the dependency injection configuration. And that's it, basically. You have root as a Sylius cart here, then provider, resolver, storage, etc., validation groups, and then we have configured core, controller, model, and everything else that we need. So basically, we need to override this class. Okay. First, let's add inside our core bundle, let's add some YAML file where we will enter all our configuration things. So let's add resources folder, config. Okay, it's empty, we need to include that. We will just include it here. If you have Symfony 2 plugin, you can enable it. It will be much easier for you to work. Just take care for Easy Publish that you need to change this app to Easy Publish. because your application lives in inside Easy Publish folder, not inside your. Okay. We have that included. Basically, we need to write some configuration things. We will use this Sylius cart part. Just paste it here. We don't need to override this, so we can put it out. Also, we don't need anything except this. Okay. This is how we override the controller class. We just need to write down our entire full namespace for our controller class. We will use this. Okay. Any questions so far? Except we don't have this class yet, so we need to create it. Okay. When we override something in a Sylius, we usually extend the base Sylius class, controller, whatever we are talking about, and then just override the things that we want to change or add some things that we are missing. So we will use Sylius cart item controller from Sylius cart bundle as our base cart item controller, and we will extend our base item controller. Okay, let's drop the I inside the cart regular cart item controller. At the beginning, we need to get the current cart from the user. Default is from the session, so you have the ID stored in your session. From that ID, we query to the database, get the cart with all items and everything that we need. We need to create empty item that we want to add to our cart, and then we dispatch the first event. Actually, we get all the event dispatcher, and then we are trying to call the item resolver. Item resolver hands the logic adding to the cart. So it checks, does we have enough on our inventory? Does that item exist? Is everything okay with the form regarding security checks and everything else? If everything is okay, he will add that to the cart, then dispatch some events. For example, cart change event is where we recalculate the text and similar things. Or if it fails, he will redirect you to the cart again and give you some error message. So you can see there is no Ajax here, so we need to override this section and add some Ajax response. I will give you 3 to 5 minutes to try it by yourself to do this, and then I will show you the code and pass to do everything. If you have any questions, just please raise your hand. I will try to answer you. So actually, you will need all this part of the code just if it is Ajax request, return the some array with the JSON. And regarding this resource bundle in Sylius, when you configure your models, controllers, forms, and everything, he provides you with the services as output. So you can use almost anything. I think anything as a service in Sylius. You can check it in this way, what you have. So there is a lot of services here. Or if you dump your console, you will get all the services from Sylius. So controllers, resolvers, events, handlers, calculators, settings, everything actually. Okay, this, here is the, I check out to the next step. So here is the code that I wrote for the, for this Ajax handler. So basically the logic stays the same. We still need to resolve the item. We still need to add that item to the cart, do some calculation. The good thing about this calculation is that they are handled with the events. So by this service-oriented architecture, we also have all code inside the Sylius covered with events. So when you whatever you change to your cart, you just need, in any part of the code, you just need to call these events. It will handle properly all calculation of taxes or discounts or anything that is related with the cart. The only difference from the previous controller is that I'm handling some exception message with a JSON, so I'm returning the JSON response. This is just an example how to return the exception message. Maybe the event isn't the, I don't know, something doesn't work properly on the client side, so the event is not called by the Ajax. So I have still the return and redirect to the cart page at the end of my action. So if it is Ajax, then return the array. If it is, if it's not, just redirect after add to the cart page, show to the visitor that he added to the cart, show the list of the cart, and that's like backup case if something doesn't work properly with Ajax.
What is the event is fresh, line 5-3?
Event is fresh, I don't know, out of the sleeve, but we can check it in inside the service to see what's actually happening.
Maybe you could ask Paul.
Yeah, if he implement this part. we can check it in. Just a second. Doesn't say too much. Probably something with some events are.
On a side question, I see you're dispatching 3 events. Do you always have to dispatch all of those 3s, or are there cases where you actually should dispatch only 1 or 2?
Like in this case, or on some particular.
Because if it was always all 3 together, I imagine you'd only have created 1 event.
I think the events are here because of some customization. Maybe you will need to change this action. So you will maybe have this initialized event at the beginning, then complete on the end, depends. Here, there is no such huge logic in this control that we will separate them through the controller, but we have some states through the cart where something is happening on initialize, something is happening on a cart chain, something is happening on save initialize, and then when we are showing to the clients what's happening. We want to have all of that, so we can check it. I know on the cards, on the card change, that we are recalculating the shipping costs, discounts, tax calculation, and things. We will see later. You will see on the example of tax calculation that it's hit on a card save event. This is more to allow easier customization, so you can hook on any of events. On this particular case, they are in a three lines in a row, but on some other cases, they are before rendering the form, after rendering the form, at the complete, at the error, so it's just there for hooking and do some custom logic. Okay, of course, if you check out, you will get some custom, you will get some other files, like in web bundle, there are some overrides of product page. This is Sylius product. Eva show you how to use easy product template also. I had some stupid JavaScript code to handle Ajax request to see that that works. We just need to override the page head script here to get this working, because we are extending the easy base template for using, for extending our templates. So just we need to copy this JavaScript files from Sylius part to easy. Okay, we can try this. Any questions? If you want to check out, this is the step 3, Ajax add to cart. Okay, I have some bug probably here because it's undefined, and you cannot see that the green color, I think, but actually the Ajax, it's working, so I have add to cart this item, and if we go to cart page, we should see it inside of our cart. Okay, it's here. So this works, like in, you need to add your JavaScript few lines to handle the Ajax call. You need to override cart controller with response with Ajax array, with JSON array, and that's it. Like 5 minutes of work to get adding with Ajax feature done. It's a little slower at the beginning, but later you can be really quick with these small overrides. Okay, let's move to the next task. Next task is to extend the model and do some customization. We took this big product example. You can do whatever you want. Almost every project requires some customization of the product. So for example, in this case, we did this with a big product, true or false, just regular checkbox. So first, we need to create new class for entity product. We need to configure Sylius to use that new class. We need to add field product, big product, to our database scheme and to our entity. Update, of course, our database scheme. And if we want to fully working product with the backend, we also need to override the form and views in the backend. So the logic is the same as in the previous tasks. We need to do some configuration, okay? This is how our configuration looks when we do it. So we create a new class that extends the Sylius core component product, and we add the field big product with get and set methods inside it. Also, in the next step, we override the form on the same way we extend it, and we just add our custom big product field. So you can try to add this class by yourself, just extend the Sylius component core product and the Sylius core bundle product type and add these two fields. Then I will show you how to resolve that. So simple configuration, we are only writing the lines that we are changing. We don't need to paste the entire model product configuration here, just the lines that we are changing.
By default, you have only one entity for all products?
No. By default, you have product and you have product variants. So product is like meta description about products, and then product variants are specific parts of the product. For example, if you have t-shirt, you have size, you have colors, and you have different prices for different models. So you have product variants. Then you have attributes, then you have options, and then collects everything to one complex product object, let's call it in that way. Basically, it's a product related to many product variants, and then you have a few more relationships with attributes, with options, archetypes, and everything else. Basically, on one project that we are currently working on, it's not e-commerce project, it's business application to very specific logic, but we have like product inventory. We just took the few Sylius bundles and we resolved everything in a few days. Set up, configure, add custom things in the same way as this, just using resource controller, product bundle, product variation bundle, that works pretty quick. So any component is reusable and you can use it at any project that you actually want with no full stack of Sylius components.
But so changing this one, basically you're changing the core. So the changes are going to be in all the variants as well.
Yes. But if you want to change like particular model, like a variant, then you will use Sylius product variant, not Sylius product, as your bundle configuration. I can show it. See, here is Sylius variation. So if you want to override that part, then you are dealing with this part of configuration. Again, extending that model, adding the fields that you need, and etc. For example, if you are doing something with the price or some fees, or I don't know, you will do that here. But if that's some like a meta description for all your variation, then you are on a level up. That's actually the product.
Maybe you should explain the variant, maybe. You know, what's the product variant?
Yeah,
I didn't do that.
I can try to do that. Just until this is loaded, I will show you the code. So you will need to add, if you've done this properly, you will add this entity product, okay? You will extend base product from the Sylius. You will add this private or protected variables and get and set method for set for big product field. Also, you will need to add doctrine folder here and mapping for your new class, and add this big product field, type boolean, it can be nullable, it's okay. And second part is extending the form and the backend view for that part. So extending the form is again the same thing as a model, just extending the base product type and adding this field that we need here. Okay. And regarding the templates, we have extended the web Sylius web bundle inside our web bundle, and just we need to override some templates. For example, show here, or if we want to add form, we need to add the form inside it. Regarding the Ivo's question, I will try to explain you how products are made inside the Sylius.
Иво, имаш пуняч, може да се работи.
Notice here that this product contains variants, because we will talk about it. Okay, so the easiest example is a t-shirt. We have a t-shirt, for example, PHP Summer Camp t-shirt that is white with some logo and that things. But the shirt has a size, so like S, M, L, XL, XXL. Here, I hope you can see it. Okay. Also, the shirt can have a color. Like this one is white, but it can be the blue or it can be a yellow. From that options, we can create variants. So, for example, one variant is a M size red T-shirt. Or green size large t-shirt. And combination of all these options give us all possible variants inside the Sylius. And you can see them here. So basically, this product that we are overriding at the moment is like our meta description. And then this product variant is a particular one type of that product. For example, here is a size M and the color green. And every of these product variants can have its own price or inventory levels here as a current stock. It can be available or we can remove that from showing. And that's basically, I think, do you have questions or is this clear enough? So it's one-to-many relationship. One product can have many variants, depends on options. We can, of course, delete some or we can generate them. That is how basically it works. Of course, all products can have some attributes. I don't know, like weight or something else that we, from some reason, don't want to push to the options. The easiest thing is when you have one product related to only one product variant. That's the easiest thing when you have regarding implementation. Okay, any questions or we can move to next task. Okay, the next task is a tricky one. I can first show you the checkout process. That's just to see how it works. So basically, we have some product in a cart. We can check out. First step in checkout is a login, but as I'm already logged in, I'm going to the next step, it's addressing step. So I can enter some information here, like company name, first name, last name, country, province, street, etc. Okay. Also, I can use different billing address from my shipping address, that's already implemented inside it. Then we go to next step. Next step is a delivery method. This is standard regular that you get out of the box from the Sylius. So second step is picking up the shipping method, for example, FedEx World Shipping. I'm sorry that screen is so bad, but we have price, different price for every different shipping method, and shipping method depends of your country or region or whatever you define in the backend. So, for example, if I pick Croatia here, I will get only FedEx World shipping, but I pick the United States, so I'll get also the regular FedEx. Next is a payment method. Sylius uses Payum framework for integrating the payment method, so you can get a lot of payment methods out of the box just configuring the few lines. These are predefined already in a Sylius. So dummy PayPal Express checkout, B2Bill offsite, Stripe checkout and offline method. Dummy is great for demo purposes. So next is a summary page where we get total that we need to pay and we can see all the discounts or anything that we get during our checkout process. For example, if you implement the custom discount for a particular payment method, then you will show discounts here to user. Okay, placeholder. If we have credit card payment, he will show us now credit card form, but this will just complete the payment process. And it will show us flash message at the header, and we will later override that to show the thank you page to our customers. So that's one mistake in this standard process is that there is no thank you page, it's just flash message added to the event and then redirected to home page, but later we will change that. Okay. So our next task is add calculation of tax for our shipping method. So when I pick the shipping method at the moment, the tax didn't do calculation for shipping method. So we will see how to do that. So the process is again the similar as with the controller or product model. We need to create a new class for shipping model. For shipping method, we need to implement taxable interface that will require us to add some new fields to the database. And then we need to override taxation processor to include calculation of tax for shipping. This is our service for calculating the taxation in a checkout process. So the flow will be again the same. Open your config file. We can check it in Sylius YAML what we need to. So shipping is here. Okay, we have Sylius shipping bundle and we need to override class for a shipping method. I can copy paste this. And I need only to override model and the form for this task. So
I think you did too much of cutting.
Yeah, you have right probably. No, I'm not. It's okay.
No, the classes.
Yeah, classes. Thanks. This is configuration. Now we need just to add the classes for these two, for the form and for the model. I'll give you a few minutes to try it by yourself. So don't forget to add new doctrine configuration for your shipping model. And don't forget to extend this shipping taxable interface, and you will see what you need to add when you implement this taxable interface. You will see what fields you need to add to your shipping model. of course, after you change your models in a Sylius, you need to update your database. So just to increase terminal preferences.
I think you can do the command plus.
Okay, it will work. Can you all read this, or I need to increase fonts a little more? So you need to update your models on the database so this will work. Doctrine schema update, force, but I think my database is already updated, so it won't change a thing. Yeah.
That's the difference between custom attributes in Easy and custom attributes in Sylius. In Sylius, we need to update the schema, which is more a traditional way how to do it. And in Easy, we have the meta model, so you do it in the administration interface with no database model changes.
Okay, I already check out, so let's see the code. So we extended the model for shipping method. We extended base shipping method from Sylius here, from Sylius core component. We added text category with get and set methods because that textable interface requires from us to have get text category. Also, we changed our model for shipping method, so we add this relation to taxation model text category. Okay, it's many to one relationship. Also, we override the form for shipping method type, same as for product type. So we add this field. Notice this null here, it's actually entity. And we changed our backend templates for shipping methods. We override the form, we override the macros, and we override the show. In form, we just add the field text category here, okay? In a macros, in a listing, I wanted to add also text category, so this is the header. And if shipping method is defined, I will just output the text category name in our index listing. Also, inside the particular shipping method, I add a text category to show if it is defined, of course, here. We can check this inside our backend to see if it works. So if you go to shipping methods here, in your configuration here you have shipping methods. So here is tax category. We didn't define any tax cut. We just updated the model's override to use our model. So, but we need in administration configure these shipping methods to use some of tax categories. So I can edit all of them. So this is the macro override. Give us this. This is index listing like grid or something like that. And we will show the tax category here. If we go inside our form, we can see that we have tax category here.
Can you increase the size?
Yes. Okay, this is the form. Everything is here from default series installation, and we can change the tax category, say, okay, it's a taxable goods category. I can save that. I will save for all methods. Okay, this is the show template. So we have text category here. It's taxable goods now because we save it. And if we go back to the index listing, we will see that we have now text categories listed inside our template. Okay, so all shipping methods now have tax category that will be used for calculation of tax. But we are still not done. We need to do one more thing. It's overriding the service that's actually calculating our shipping, our taxation, our tax, sorry. So this is the regular taxation processor, and he'll only do the calculation for products. You can see that here. For order, get items, for every item, calculate the tax, and then give us the total of that tax. We can have different taxes for different products inside the Sylius. So for example, in Croatia, we have different taxes for different type of products. That's a normal thing in e-commerce solution, so it's already implemented inside the Sylius and it works. Okay, and our taxation is extending base taxation processor, and we are adding this thing here. So for all shipments, because we can also have different shipping methods for different type of products inside the checkout process, that's more advanced case. So we are creating many shipments for one order. For example, if you have some items on your inventory, but some you don't have, you can split that in a few shipments and then said, okay, I shipped the first part of the shipment, then I will send the second part of the shipment. So for each shipment, just calculate the tax same as for the products. That's the thing that we have override here. Okay, but one more thing we need to do is override the events for shipping calculation. That was questioned before for events in a cart, you asked. So this is one of the events where we apply the taxes on a cart, say, okay. We also do tax calculation on security pre-complete and addressing pre-complete. But I wanted to add this also on checkout finalize pre-complete. Before the showing the summarized page, I want again to calculate all the taxes regarding the shipping method I have picked, and then to show total tax to our visitor, client, whatever you want. So actually, the only thing I add here is overriding the Sylius order processing taxation class to use our class. Now, so this taxation process now using our class, and I added one custom event for tax calculation. If I want to remove some event, I will just delete it here, and that's how it works. It's Symfony way. It's nothing. There is no any differences between any other Symfony application regarding overriding the templates, services, or anything else. Okay, I will show you that this works. Just I need to update the tax rates, because if I pick the United States, I think the configuration is that the tax rate is zero. Yeah, rest of the world is zero. So I will set it to 10%, for example. Also, notice here in a configuration of your tax, sorry.
This is very short. I know nothing about web shops. Why do you attach by default taxation processor to a shipping method? I would imagine that taxes are more related to the type of goods you're selling, not the way you're shipping them.
This is just example how simple it is to add a taxation to any part of your of things that you are billing to the client. For example, if you're using from one of my projects that I worked on, I got from the third party shipping provider, I got the net price without tax. So I need to include calculation of tax for that shipping. For example, I get 10 euros as a amount for the shipping, but to end client, I need to charge 10 euros plus 23% of the tax. That's example. In a out of the box of the Sylius, there is no calculation of tax for shipping methods. So if you want to add it, this is the solution how to add it. Just add textable interface, implement textable interface, extend your model, and override the service calculator for shipping. That's the idea behind this task.
Yes, so this is an extension to the taxation thing. So I think in European Union, you also now pay local VAT instead of like remote VAT. And in the US also, you pay tax for the state that the product is shipped to. So it is very valid kind of thing. But not for me. I haven't worked with that. But I can imagine there's many cases this is valid things to handle. And it's possible to handle, that's good.
I mean, related to taxation to shipment, there are many use cases, yeah.
Yeah.
But as in Germany, you usually don't add the tax and the checkout. You need to show it in the details, even in the shop, in the storefront. So this is a real... this was an issue in the implementation when where do you show the VAT even before the checkout process or before the card and you need to calculate it?
Yeah, you have calculators for that. You have already services that can show you the tax on templates, so it's not a problem. You can there is two, you can see here. You can say, is your tax included in price or not included? And then calculators and the helpers for the view know how to calculate the tax. Do they need to add it to the net price and then show it to the client? Or they are already included, they just need to do recalculation and show it. It's possible to do that in the templates. But in checkout process, you're already at the first step and your cart summary, you have tax and total for the items. But at the end, at this summarized process, you can show the total amount because it's after you pick your shipping method. You don't know which the shipping method is at the beginning of the checkout process. So this is additional thing that you add during your process, and then you can show it to the client. This is very simple, extending and overriding of taxation for shipping methods. There are of course much advanced and trickier integrations that can cover all the things.
And the included in the price option would also reduct them or reduce it from the in the cart and in the bill, and everything works with this included in the price option.
Sorry, can you repeat the question?
If you use this included in the price, it would.
Yeah, it will show the tax. It's
so it would mean that you show the same amount in detail on detail page, and you're able to add another field by calculating the VAT if you have to show
it. Yeah, of course.
And then after putting it in the cart, it should even say in the cart that there is already tax included, and it wouldn't add anything.
That's the regular case. For example, in Croatia, you are showing total price with tax. And then when you are showing the cart or you are showing the summary page, you are showing, okay, your total for payment is this, but your tax is this, and your total of items without tax is this. So we also need to show all the prices separately, not just one price together. Especially on the invoices where we have very strange laws, so it can cover a lot of things.
Could you show, you said that documentation is still a thing, but is it, where would I start searching for this documentation regarding all this text method?
Okay, this is the documentation at the moment. It's on docs.sylius.org. Mm-hmm. So some of things are documented pretty good. For example, resource controller, I think, is pretty good documented. But regarding taxation, here is something. That's it. But basically, you want really to read the code. So there, it's. I'll show you. You don't want to read this documentation.
So the point with the taxation is that if you know the shipping method, then of course you can show all the taxes in the basket. But if the chooser of the shipping method is after the basket, then of course you will add and calculate the taxes afterwards.
Yeah, so
yeah, So, but with Sylius, as I understand, Antonio, is that you can add, you can configure where the calculator, where the tax calculation will happen. So.
I think it would really help to have a best practice for the European Union as out of the box or some default case to just have the default configuration, for example, Germany or whatever, because it is very different from what comes with the default installation now, right now. Because you have no default location, you add the text.
That things you're actually configuring in the backend, you don't need to do some additional coding for that. So you have configuration, you have zones, then text is related to the zones, then calculation of that depends on the zone. So for example, we have this example here that the rest of world text, just a second, was 0%. So for example, for Germany, you can say it's, I don't know, 18%, how much?
I know that, of course, but there is, there are like 6 forms you need to have a concept for and all that. And the only thing I say is if there's a best practice how to configure those 5 forms per region, that would help a lot, I think, to customize, because this is the main thing and it's quite complicated.
Yeah, but regarding the configuration of tax, we didn't have, we work with Norway clients, we did with the Croatian clients. We didn't have any problems with configuration of the tax. It's quite simple from the back end. The only thing is that if you need to add something like that for adding the calculation of tax for example, shipping method, then you need to do some coding. But setting up the tax wasn't the problem for any project, as I know for now.
No, no, it's just that you can, it's regulated by law, and you can pretty good have a best practice for every country. For that, and I think that would help people coming into that.
Yeah, probably too.
That is. Yeah.
Thanks. You're welcome. Okay, we will just change this tax for rest of the world and then try the checkout process again. Of course, you can you see there is calculator here for we are using default calculator here. If you have some really custom logic, you just need to implement a calculator for shipping and for tax, and then do whatever you need in a custom way. Okay, let's.
So we need to switch the design. So it would be good to extend the base layout.
Yeah, that's the next thing to do. But we can do that. I can check out to show that, okay? Because I will need to repeat the entire process again. So this is add taxation. I show you how to do that. And next task for us is overriding the templates for cart and checkout to use base easy template. So you can just check out. It's a really simple task to see how it works.
Yeah, so it's basically the template, the Sylius templates for checkout process, which are several of them, like basket, shipping, text, the confirmation, etc. They just extend the demo bundle base layout.
Just checkout to this step. Okay, you will get some templates here. So notice it's a Sylius web bundle, easy Sylius web bundle, actually the one that we created. And we just took the files from Sylius web bundle here. And we placed it on the same location. as here, but inside our bundle. So we wanted to override cart and checkout steps. Okay, in our bundle we have these two folders, cart, checkout, and step. And we have all files that we want to override. And the override is quite similar one, simple one, sorry. We just change this line here. So we are now using easy demo bundle page layout instead of Sylius. Sylius front-end layout. That's all what we need to do. So copy-paste these five files inside proper folder, and then just override that one line, actually change that one line. Okay. If we go back to our application after we have did that, add this to cart. How much time? We have 10 minutes. Yeah.
10 minutes.
Okay. Okay, if we go to our cart now, you see that we have different template than previously. So we are now extending the easy demo page layout, and we're just including our Sylius templates inside of it. It's not designed perfect, but it...
Isn't that cool? You did never kind of client request that it says, oh, I have a Magento, let's say, installation, and we want to have the same header and footer, auto-updated. You did that one? I think a lot of us did that kind of things. So this one-liner solved that issue.
Yeah, that's nice. We have two more tasks to do in 10 minutes. I will try
maybe,
to...
Maybe just do one.
One, okay, then idea was to show you how Sylius discounts component works, but you can check it that in a backend, it's quite easy to understand, and you can create discounts based on users, items, items total, items count items, coupon based, without coupons, whatever you want. There is quite a lot of complex combination that you can do, and you pick the rules and then just add the action, what do you want when something happens. For example, if someone buys free product, give him four product for free, or 10% discount or whatever. But as we had the question about Sylius checkout process, how to override it, I will go to that task. So I will show you how to override checkout scenario and how to show the thank you page to end user and not to redirect him to the home page and show him the flash message. So we need to think about few things here. First is one that we need to override checkout scenario. So in checkout process in Sylius, we are using flow bundle that actually remembers on which step are you and what's happening in your history. So the first step is security step, then we have addressing step, then we have payment step, then we have summarize step, purchase step, and then, of course, completed, actually, thank you, redirect page. So, I'll check out to this to show you the code. Again, everything is a services, so the Sylius integration. So it's quite easy to override things. Okay, we will do this in a core bundle. So we have checkout, and we have checkout process scenario. This is our custom one. just drop the I here. We have steps security, addressing, shipping, payment, finalized purchase. And after this, we are redirected to Sylius homepage. We don't want this. We want to redirect our client visitor to our custom thank you page action. So we will override this. We will took again, we will extend this checkout process scenario, and we will change this only this line to thank you page. Okay. This thank you page is a regular action that renders some template and do some logic. So we need to have some custom checkout controller here, and this is our action inside that checkout controller. So we get the cart provider. Again, it's a service. We can check it. It has some methods to getting the ID from the session, to getting the cart from the database. If we don't have order that has completed that as a null, we don't have the... Actually, if we don't have completed that set as some date, then order is not completed, so we are throwing the not found exception because we cannot complete the checkout process with some order that is already completed. And of course, after we get the order from our database, for we need to abandon that card to remove it from the client session. And we need to render some template. It's very similar template that renders only thank you for your order. Your order number is something. Okay. To override this checkout scenario process, we need to override his class. So we setting Sylius checkout scenario class to our checkout process scenario. And that's basically the main thing that we need to do. But we need to change something else. It's event listener for purchase. So if we see the base purchase listener, we will see that after he get the state is pending or completed, that he will abandon the cart and he will return to the flow. But in our action, it won't be possible to get that cart here because it is already abandoned. So we want to override that listener and change it a little bit. Okay, this is the, again, extending the standard one and changing the thing, and we only change that we remove this. That's all that what we are changing. Of course, we need to say in our configuration file that we are now using our new custom listener. Okay. And we can now do this checkout process to see how it works. Okay, we have some cart here. I will go to checkout. An entire checkout, you will notice now, is extending easy template. Just regarding the one very important thing regarding checkout process. Entire checkout process is in Sylius core bundle, and you have for every step you have service for that. Actually, it's a controller. And if you open any of these, for example, addressing step, you will notice that you have events through the entire process of addressing. So you have initialize addressing event, you have pre-complete, you have after complete event. Of course, you have actions for rendering the template and moving to next. This is the part of the scenario flow bundle. Then we say this step is completed, go to the next, and next step will be the shipping method step. Okay, go back to template. This is the form that was in two columns in easy, but we are not designers, so it works. Okay, this is addressing step. It requires some CSS or changing the HTML, but it's... Okay, we can pick FedEx World Shipping, and we have some problems. It worked good for 3 hours almost.
It worked last night at 4 a.m.
Okay, but it works, it works. I will pick dummy method here. We will see now calculation of tax. Okay, we have no tax, 10%. Same as in Croatia. And we will place order, and we will need, we should see the thank you page. Okay, it's here. That's it. So actually everything works.
You just forget to override the page layout for the thank you.
Yeah, because I added before we override the templates. So that's one very simple way how to override the checkout process, but you can change anything. Some things you can resolve with events, so you don't need to override the step controller services, but sometimes you need to go inside it and change it. There is no
other. Any questions?
Yeah.
We have a few more minutes and then the lunch. So what do you think? Any comments, any feedback? Does it make sense maybe to try it out? You have the code.
Was this too much, or you have idea how the things work, how easy it is to change something actually in Sylius, and in same thing is for easy Sylius combination?
Have you encountered any use cases where you were not able to use the basic overriding functionality of just changing parameters and then overriding your classes?
You can always override. It depends. The only issue can be if there is some problematic logic behind it, but it's just matter of configuration, so you can always override anything.
But it's abstracted to the extent that you really haven't encountered such an issue where things haven't been put into the configuration, so you wouldn't be able to override, for instance.
No, I didn't have that kind of problem yet. So.
I had a small problem a few months ago with the Easy kernel, the new one. It was kind of, I think it was fixed. Yeah, that's why I'm looking at Bertrand. We had you could actually abstract the some service, you know, you could extend it, but the class that was, you know, used had private properties, and then it was a bit difficult to extend. But I think that one was fixed. So that kind of problems might happen here also, but you can. But then maybe a quick pull request can solve it also.
Yeah.
Any other questions? Suppose everybody is hungry and very hungry. Yeah. Thank you.
You can also send us email if you have any questions.